driver's license yet?
No.
But you can fly an aeroplane?
Yes, that's right.
It's an opportunity that no other kid can get.
If you had to guess who was flying this aeroplane, the guy on the left in the pilot's uniform or the kid on the right in the school uniform, you'd pick the one on the left, right? Well, you'd be wrong. David Hart is in Year 12 at Melville Senior High School. He's also a pilot who, in a couple of months, will be able to fly solo.
It's pretty cool for a 17-year-old to be up there flying an aeroplane, isn't it?
Definitely. I know a few other people who do it.
So today what we're going to actually do is we're going to look at climbing.
This is a classroom with a difference. No textbooks today. It's aviation studies where Year 8 students learn all about flying.
You can level off now, Michael. So lower the nose.
Teacher and pilot Randall Brink says these 12 and 13-year-olds are a bit young for the real thing.
So in order to get them ready for that, we do these flight simulator exercises in the class, going through all the different lessons one by one, so they have some familiarity with it when they get out there and get in the real aircraft.
I imagine this would be a pretty popular course.
Oh, very popular.
When they're 15, they'll be ready for flying lessons, turn 16, and you can legally fly a plane on your own.
They'll be flying a plane, it's probably worth between $50,000 to $100,000, and they don't have a driver's license, so it's a little bit scary for me as an instructor, especially when I'm sending them solo, so I'm sitting with my fingers crossed and hoping that they're going to be okay.
Right, circuit clear for takeoff, heading off, Yankee. Alright, you have control.
17-year-old David is on the runway at Jandakot Airport. The Year 8 boys, Daniel, Lewis and Liam, watch enviously from the terminal.
50.
And takeoff on board the Cessna 172. A joy flight over Perth and the Swan River most kids could only dream of. While David was flying high, we asked the boys on the ground why they chose aviation studies.
It would be pretty cool to fly a plane before you can drive a car. You'd be able to fly to school.
I just like the feeling of flying and the idea of flying.
Okay, what about the real reason?
Really gets us out of the other boring subjects and we can have an hour of fun.
Quite nice to go from maths and English, science, all those sort of heavy subjects, into just learning about planes.
Liam Pulford is proof that schoolboys do grow up to be pilots.
I got my pilot's license about 5 months before I got my driver's license. So, you know, I was flying. I would have to ride my bike down to the airfield, put my bike and tie it up, go in, sign out an aeroplane and go flying.
Liam went from Melville High School class of 88 to Air Force fighter jet pilot, and now he flies all over the world on Qantas 747s.
I'd say I'm living my dream. If that's what somebody else wants to do, then sure, they could look up and see what I've done as an example of that it can be achieved.
As today's flight comes to an end, David pulls off a perfect landing. You'd think the Cessna was being flown by an old pro, not a schoolboy.
Oh, that was great. Loved it. Every flight's always interesting.
David was flying that plane during the whole time. He took it off, he landed, he did everything. So he's an exceptional young man to come this far so early in the piece. Yeah.
People see that. They're quite amazed that you can actually do it. But obviously, if you have the right sort of attitude and responsibilities that go with it, then it's a good enough age to start.
These are our pilots of tomorrow.
Yes, they sure are.